Welcome back to the CSC Garage. In this episode, I'm going to show you some of the control features of your ES5. Let's get started. Let's start with the key fob. The key fob has a lock, an unlock, and an alarm button. It also has a built-in key. And you might need to use this key if you didn't have power to the bike. If the batteries were disconnected or you're completely depleted at 0%, I can't turn the bike on or even get in the seat without using this key. So I can pull down the little door covering the keyhole, insert the key, push in till it clicks, and then turn to the lock, and that unlocks the seat. Now I have access to my charger, to my batteries. I can plug them or charge them as needed. Now, let's take a look at the fork lock. Right now, the ignition switch is not powered up, so I can't turn the bike on, and I also can't use the fork lock or release the seat. If I push in, though, you hear it beep, and that powers up the lock. Now, I could turn the bars all the way to the left, lock the fork, and then when this gets out of proximity to the ignition switch, maybe 20 feet or so, it will remain locked in that position until I'm ready to unlock it. Now I can unlock it with the key fob, or I could push the ignition switch in to power back up when the fob's close to it, hold it in, turn it, and I can free up that fork lock. Now let's turn the ES5 to the on position. I can't turn the ignition switch because it's powered down, but I am in proximity to the switch with the key fob, so I can push it in, it powers the lock up. Now I'm able to turn the switch to the right, which turns the dash on, and the bike's powered up. We now have the switch unlocked, the bike's powered on, the dash is lit, we're ready to ride. However, it's still in park mode. So we're gonna depress the parking switch on the right-hand switch housing. Now the P's off, and we'll choose which mode we want, Eco, Comfort, or Sport. We'll start out with Eco. However, it's still not ready. This isn't green, so nothing happens when I turn the throttle until I lift the side stand. When I lift the side stand, that safety switch is now ready to go. We see that it's green, meaning when I give it throttle, it's going to take off. Now, we can use the center stand. It's on the side stand, which also serves as a safety switch, but if you might choose to use your center stand just to get it up in a more stable position for parking. Couple of the features on the dash itself, you've got a trip meter, an odometer, your speedometer, a power meter showing the power being used at that moment, and then the battery state of charge. You'll also notice that when the bike is on the center stand, it's ready. So the rear wheel will spin if the side stand is not down or if the parking is not enabled. Now, the bike does come with some other features. Your turn signals, they cancel by pushing the button back in. You've got your high and low beam, your horn, your cruise control. Cruise control works by powering under the throttle, and while you're holding the throttle, press the button down. It will then set the cruise control, which will be on until you press the button again or operate any of the brakes. It's got a reverse. To use the reverse, I'm going to hold the reverse down while giving it throttle. You've got a burst button. This is a power burst. You'll notice on the dash it goes from eco to burst mode when I'm holding that down. On some of our other models, this is just a momentary switch for a high beam. It's a flasher, but on this model, it actually gives you a burst of power for up to 6 minutes. And then, of course, the mode and set buttons. Mode goes between the different dash display modes, and then your set button will allow you to reset your trip meter as needed. Thanks for joining us once again at the CSC Garage. I enjoyed showing you just how easy it is to get up and running on your ES5. Until next time, enjoy the ride.